Welcome to Rockit Garage, and we are continuing on the poor man's long travel with the 82 Ford Bronco. If you haven't seen the last episode, we tore the whole front end apart and cut the lower ball joints out and then repositioned them out 7/8 of an inch further than where they were. Anyways, it's probably a couple weeks for you guys, but this is the same day for me. And we have everything welded enough to where the truck's not gonna blow apart. But we didn't final weld because I want to make sure that my calculations were correct, because I'm a little nervous because I just cut the front suspension out of my truck and it will never be the same. Hopefully for the better.
There are no guts, differentials out of it, no axle shafts. We are just testing for camber. We have just one pass on the lower ball joint. Same as over here, 7/8 of an inch. We have the 1.5 inch spacers, F250 coils, still on stock radius arms. And actually, I'll show you guys this. Look at the top ball joint. That is 90 degrees. This thing has zero caster laid in it because of the radius arm. So if you're wondering what radius arms are gonna do, and you can see the angle, definitely in the bushing. See how it's tilted? We are going to fix that by building radius arms and tilting this axle out from under itself. Look at that. That is eyeball perfect. That's pretty good. How does it sit? Oh, it's pretty level. This truck has a 2-inch block in the rear and essentially 3-inch lift in the front. The 31s still don't look terrible on this truck, even though they only measure out to about 28 inches tall, which is, that's big tire for you. This is going to be a rough estimate of the actual camber. I'm gonna measure off the end of the hub, which should be mostly square. What is that? Yeah, 89, 1 degree of negative camber, not bad.
89.8 degrees of negative camber.
So that means I might have went a little too far on this side.
Now that we have fixed the camber issue, they're well within the adjustable range of a camber bushing, which is perfect. Now we got to go to caster, and this is obviously drooped all the way down, but we're sitting at 11.8. negative caster, which means that the wheels are underneath itself. What we really want, and the go fast Bronco F-150, you know, TTB stuff, if you're gonna go fast, these TTBs love a lot of caster. I am going to aim for 10 degrees to 12 degrees of caster in the positive direction. That way, when it's drooped out all the way, we'll still have positive caster even though the wheels aren't touching the ground. That's the goal. How I'm gonna do that? Still figuring that out. Now, if my theory is correct, because I've searched every forum and every website and every video that I can find, people say, well, just measure the caster. And I'm like, well, what's an easy way in your own garage or on your driveway that you could measure caster? The way I'm thinking this is, this coil is obviously sprung forward. This mount technically should be zero. This ball joint, this top ball joint, is off-centered to the rear, which means everything from the factory should be set with these radius arms flat. If I get this, that wind is just killer. If I set the coil bucket at zero, this should be pretty close to factory. Here's a little sneak peek. I rebuilt the drive shaft in the last episode for this truck, which was like a $100 rebuild kit off Jeff's Bronco Graveyard. And that was, I felt like it was high. And then I was stumbling upon the internet one day. This was $200 brand new. So that's U-joints, the double cardan, the slip joint, everything is new. And I'm really kind of kicking my butt that I didn't look that up and find that earlier. But for my research, the rear drive shaft is also the front drive shaft. So I'm just gonna put the rear one that I rebuilt in the front, put this in the rear, and if the front ever gives me problems, I mean, it's $200. So this should solve. I didn't waste money, okay? All right. Anyways, moving on. 1¼ inch Heims. These things are pretty beefy. Got them off Amazon, okay? And then I got these Rough Stuff frame brackets that these Heims joints will sit in.
Radius arm is disconnected. We have it set up at, we'll call it 0. And you can see this ball joint is now kicked back. And you can see the bushing is essentially level. So I need to measure this ball joint and compare it, I guess, and then figure out where that thing's gonna shoot off to. So I have the mount and the Heim joint all put together, clamped on the frame. That position is about 11 inches longer from that flange to the center line of the hole. So not quite as long as I wanted it to be, but there's a bolt there and then the frame kicks. So it's gonna be kind of difficult to, I know people do it, but I'm trying to do this on the easy. Got the caster set where I want it. I'm still gonna measure the wheelbase to make sure, but chop the back of the radius arm off. This inside diameter is 2 inches, outside diameter is 2 inches. Slide it in and it'll sit right on the bottom right there. And I'll slide it in as far as I can without touching stuff. If it works, awesome. I'll finish boxing it up later. I just wanna make sure that, again, my math is right because this is the first time doing a long travel Ford TTB and I've wanted to do one for 10 years and I'm doing it. No going back. If y'all don't have a torch set or a mini torch set, this one's from Harbor Freight. It's epic. That took me, I don't know, about a minute. Along with, you know, the map gas works pretty good, but with ball joints and bushings, body mounts and stuff like that, dude, a torch is just bee's knees. Another side note, the best air hammer on the planet, PH3050. So this is what I got. The bracket, the Heim, the bung, 20 inch piece of tubing, radius arm cut, wheelbase set to 104.5. The book says 104.7, which there's some adjustment there. And what else? Oh, caster set at 7 degrees. Coil bucket set at 2.5. And it's at 16.5 all the way to there. It was 16¼. And then when I put it on the ground and bumped it around, it was 16.5. I think that was just with the camber change, kind of messed with the height. Anyways, I think that looks awesome. Looks pretty snazzy. This is 33 inches long from this bolt hole to that bolt. From that pivot bolt to this bucket bolt, it's 32.5. So we're around an inch in a triangulation or whatever you want to call it. So I think being almost equal length, that's gonna give the most flex possible. I don't see a benefit as far as going further back. Three sides of that bracket welded. These are kind of burned in.
front suspension's all put together. Look at that tie rod. I have another one. Coil bucket looks way better. Standing straight up. The caster looks really good. If you're wondering how long something like this takes to fabricate, I have 19 hours as of right now into this front end. That is measuring, tearing apart, assembling it. This is the sixth time I've had this together. So we'll blow it apart one more time, final weld, paint, put it all back in. So I'm gonna say I'm gonna have about 30 hours into this front suspension, which I was expecting 40. And if I come under that, then I'm ecstatic. Let's put the wheels on and see what this thing looks like in the driveway. Okay, it's finally time to retire these stock mirrors, which is sad because I really like this look and I can't find this style mirror anywhere. This is the only mirror that I could find that is supposedly fitting for an 82 Ford Bronco, which it does the job. I just don't think they look as slick. There it is, all mocked up. Camber's a little off on this side. Pretty darn good on this side. Went ahead and replaced both inner tie rods. Coils look good. Looks like it's sitting nose happy, but it's pretty even. The ground is just not level. There is the radius arms. Pretty much the same. 7 degrees of caster. First phase of the poor man's long travel kit is done. Once I get the shop cleared out again, I will blow everything apart, final weld everything, put gussets on it, and throw everything back in it. And we will have a running, driving 82 Ford Bronco with essentially a long travel kit in the front. No coilovers yet, but we'll get to that. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching, liking, subscribing, commenting. This truck has come a long way since, well, when I first started working on it. I only piddle on it here and there, just in between projects, but we've got a lot of work done in a short amount of time. And I think by the end of spring, this thing will be hopefully jumping the whoops. I mean, there's not really desert here. You get what I mean? It could if I had dunes, okay? Maybe I'll go to the dunes. And you're not gonna wanna miss what I have coming up. These right here are gonna change in a very good way. Can't wait to show you guys. Anyways, thanks for watching. See you guys in the next one.